Namaste friends, good evening and welcome. This is your astrologer friend Rajiv Nath, back with you with another video. See, I've already announced that I'm going to start a new KP batch, but somehow, you know, due to some personal reasons, some domestic commitments, I've not been able to I'm not going to be able to start the batch in time, that is 1st November. So I have not taken, you know, any enrollments also. Names are there, people have approached me, but मैंने किसी को कोई definite time नहीं बताया है, और ना मैंने किसी से कोई fees accept की है, because it's slightly fluid. Maybe I'll be able to start only by, you know, the middle of November, not before that. I was all prepared to start from 1st November, but 1st November to aa gaya, it's only 3 days away, so I will not be able to start. But anyway, this is a demonstration, a demo video in continuation with the two videos that I have already posted. Wo agar aapne nahi dekha hoga mere two videos, to usko zarur dekh lijiyega. One is, you know, what KP is. The first video, why KP and what is KP. The second was on the sublord in KP. And of course, it's all connected, you know, the golden rules of KP ke saath hi sare connected hai. But what ultimately, how to predict in KP and what importance is the sublord? Sublords, as you would all know, do tarah ke hote hain. That I'll come when I start the video. So I'm going to share a screen with you without wasting further time. Anyway, the introductory part, let me explain to you. Sublords do prakar ke hote hain. There are two types of sublords. One is the cuspal sublord, jo ki humare houses hote hain, 1 to 12 houses, un sab ke bhi sublords hote hain. They play a big role. And then there are the planetary sublords. Every planet has a sublord. That means every planet is sitting in the zodiac in a particular degree, which is the sub, the eighth sub area, that degree, and it has a lord. So isko hum sublord bolte hain. How they play out in KP? Please follow my video very carefully. You see, this is where, you know, why our predictions go wrong. Isko main aaj koshish karunga explain karne ki, ki how an event takes place or does not take place, even after, you know, if you don't know the concepts of sublords. Agar aapko sublords pe clarity nahi hai, to aap event ko predict nahi kar sakte hain. Sometimes it may pass, you know, you may not even require, you may predict an event without using the sublords. It may come true. It may, your prediction may prove correct. Ultimately, you will find that, you know, the sublords were supporting your prediction. But at times you will make a prediction where you will, you know, aap stellar level signification se aapne prediction kar diya, but wo aapka prediction galat ho jayega. Usko explain karne ke liye, let us, you know, ek main chart aapke samne khol raha hoon, aur usme mere course contents ke bhi wo thode se details hain. Full details agar aapko chahiye to you can get in touch with me. Isme dekhiye, maine likha hua hai left side mein, dekhiye, this is the chart that I am going to discuss. Ye left side mein yahan pe likha hua hai KP batch starting from November 21. There will be 27 classes. Contact numbers हमारे दिए हुए हैं. Fees वगैरह के लिए आप लोग हमें contact कर सकते हैं, but the fees is 15,000 rupees. Okay, you can pay it in installments also. That part you can discuss with me. A number of students have got in touch with me. I have noted down their names and reserved their slots. Or कब start करूँगा? Most probably it will be sometime in the middle of November. I am not giving the exact date. So, but then you see what. आपको क्या मैं पढ़ाऊंगा? एक तो मैंने दो डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन वीडियोस दिए हैं ओवर द लास्ट 10 डेज. डेमो वीडियो नंबर 1, डेमो वीडियो नंबर 2, आप उनको जरूर देख लीजिएगा. इफ यू हैव नॉट वॉच्ड देम, यू कैन गो टू माय चैनल एंड वॉच देम, एंड आफ्टर दैट ओनली, यू नो, ये आप इस वीडियो को देखिए. This is a very, very important and interesting video. So we go now today, hum sublords ko discuss karenge. Aur usme sublords mein bhi hum cuspal sublord pe discussion karenge. Which I don't know, somehow, one minute, just give me one second. I'll show you some books. One or two books I'll show you before, you know, proceeding with whatever, what I'm trying to teach you. Ye cuspal sublords ka role jo hai, even Krishnamurti ji himself did not lay a lot of emphasis on cuspal sublords. He did lay a lot of emphasis on cuspal sublords, but how they act, वो उसने थोड़ा सा उसको फर्दर रिसर्च किया है. उनके एक शिष्य थे मिस्टर के एम सुब्रमण्यम. ओके, इनकी ये तीन किताबें हैं. सी द सबलॉर्ड स्पीक्स, दिस इज द बुक. यू कैन सी इट, यू कैन टेक डाउन द नेम, एंड इफ यू नीड टू गेट दीज बुक्स, यू कैन, आई कैन हेल्प यू आउट विद देम. देखिए सबलॉर्ड स्पीक्स, दिस इज वॉल्यूम वन, ओके, बाई के एम सुब्रमण्यम. Of course, the gentleman is no more, Mr. K.M. Subramaniam. And this is where you will find, you know, the importance of the cuspal sublord. Ek kitab ye hai. Then there are three volumes. Patli patli kitabe hai, but this is Sublord Speaks, volume 2. Okay, aap ye manga sakte hain. And then there is Sublord Speaks, volume 3. I would strongly urge you and advise you to have these KP books in your collection. Tabhi aap ja karke sublord ka concept jo hai wo theek tarike se samajh payenge. Main close up kar raha hu, aap log isko dekh lijiye. Aur zarur I can help you out with these books if you can't get them. But then isme aapko sara, and I have been emphasizing in all my KP batches the importance of the cuspal sublord. And where predictions and how predictions go wrong. Now, I'll ये example chart आपके सामने एक है. देखिए उसको मैं अपने batches में पढ़ा चुका हूँ. But today the same chart I'm going to present it in a different manner. You know, इसमें जो chart हमने explain किया है, in my past videos I have discussed this chart. But I have started from the cuspal subplot. आप देखिए. If you know something about KP, of course, you know my KP batch, agar aap join karenge, to it is assumed and presumed that you have some basic knowledge of astrology or some basic knowledge of maybe KP also, the very basics. So this explanation, this demo video that I'm presenting in front of you will be understood mainly by people who already know something about KP. Okay, ab ye dekhiye, ye ek chart hai. Dekhiye yahan pe, just give me one minute. Ye cursor ko follow kiye. There is a chart of a person. The date of birth is 25/8/1956. Okay, and the time and place, everything is given. You can put it in your computer and generate this chart also. Okay, I have not given the name, the identity of the person I have hidden. Naam nahi diya hai maine. Ab aap dekhiye isme, let us aise hum chalte hain ki let us discuss his marriage. Inki shadi, he was born in 1956, and here are the, you see, the dasha periods, the mahadasha periods are here. So we presume, you know, that 56 wagara mein about 22, 23, 24, 25, this was used to be the marriageable age for boys. So in ki marriageable age, he was born in 1956. So now let us say 25. So 25 ke ye jab rahe honge, it would have been 1981. So see here, 1981 onwards. So 1974, his Venus Mahadasha started, and it was to last till 1994. So his marriageable age, let us say 22 to 28, that should have fallen in this period. Okay, he should have got married in Venus Mahadasha. Now let us see Venus. Hum marriage ke liye kya dekhte hain? Marriage ke liye, what are the combinations you would know as students of KP? Marriage kab hoti hai? Jabki 2, 7, or 11. 2, 7, or 11 ke stellar level significators ki dasha antar dasha chalti hai, to shadi is expected ki ho jayegi. To Venus Mahadasha Lord ye 20 saal 1974 se 1994 tak chala. 1974 to 1994 is Venus Mahadasha ran for 20 years. He should have gotten married in this, provided Venus was supporting, was a significator of the marriage giving houses, at least one of the houses. Let us see Venus now. What are the marriage giving houses? They are 2, 7, and 11. What is Venus signifying? We can see here Venus is signifying the second house. Okay? Venus is signifying the seventh house. And Venus is also signifying, it is signifying the 10th. So 10th is not a good house for marriage. But anyway, second or seventh ko, seventh to main house hota hai, Venus signify kar raha hai. And Mahadasha Lord, you know, even if it gives a hint for marriage, you know, if it is not denying the marriage giving houses, if it is not negating the marriage giving houses, then we say that marriage is promised or is Mahadasha mein inki shadi ho sakti thi. So Venus Mahadasha should have given him marriage. Okay. Kyunki Venus ke baad phir hame kya chahiye? Venus 2 or 7 ko kar raha hai aur 2 ko bahut strongly kar raha hai. So we needed, you know, Venus ki Mahadasha mein Sun ki antardasha aa jati, usme shadi ho sakti thi because Sun is signifying 7th. Or yeah, let us go to the 11th house. Moon is signifying 11th. Mercury is signifying 11th. So Venus ke saath Sun or even Ketu or Jupiter or Venus itself, Venus is also signifying 7th. And koi bhi inme se planet, 11th ka significator Moon ya Mercury. So Venus mein Moon, Mercury or Sun combination of Dasha, Mahadasha, Antardasha and Pratyantardasha should have given this person marriage. Because Venus, the Mahadasha Lord, is not negating marriage. It is signifying marriage. But inki shadi nahi ho pai. Okay, now he crossed 1994, Venus was over. Okay, so that time he would have been 28. Still the marriageable age is not over. Then came Sun Mahadasha. Sun Mahadasha lasted from 1994 to 2000, 6 years. Could Sun have given him marriage? Let us see the signification. This is the significator table, by the way. Could Sun have given him marriage? Sun could have given him marriage because it is signifying the seventh house very strongly. Okay, now, sorry, one step I forgot. We were talking about Venus. Now, let us see. We say that planetary sublords also play a major role. Okay, so who is the sublord of Venus? Yeh, dekhiye, yahan planetary positions hain. Venus ka sublord Saturn hai. So Saturn, if it supports Venus in marriage negotiations or marriage, if it is not a denying planet, then marriage should take place. But Venus, if the sublord vehemently denies, negates, that means if it is strongly signifying the marriage negating houses, that is 1, 6 and 11, then marriage can be denied. But here we can see that Saturn, as the sublord of the Mahadasha Lord Venus, is Saturn is signifying 3rd, 4th, 12th, okay, 3rd, 4th, 12th, 12th, and 3rd, 4th again. So none of these are marriage denying houses. So we cannot say that Saturn, as the sublord of the Mahadasha Lord, was anywhere denying marriage. Had it been denying marriage, let us understand it this way. Dekhiye, abhi main aapko farak bataunga when we come to the cuspal sublord. The stellar level main significators, sublord, should not be denying the event that we are looking at. Matlab Venus ki mahadasha mein, Venus to marriage giving houses ko signify kar raha hai. To shaadi de sakta hai. Lekin uska sublord agar negating houses ko signify karta, yani ki 1, 6 and 10, तो फिर मैरिज डिनाई हो सकती थी. लेकिन सैटर्न ना तो वन को कर रहा है, ना सिक्स को कर रहा है और ना ही टेन को कर रहा है. यू कैन सी फ्रॉम दी स्टेलर लेवल्स. सो मैरिज इज नॉट डिनाइड थ्रू दिस सब लॉर्ड. सो दैट मीन्स वीनस वॉज केपेबल कॉम्पिटेंट ऑफ गिविंग मैरिज इन इट्स महादशा बट इट डिड नॉट. ओके नाउ लेट अस सी सन. लेट अस सी सन. After Venus, Sun Mahadasha came. Sun is signifying the seventh house as an A-level significator. So it should have given marriage. Okay? Shadi nahi hui. Sun may be Venus mein nahi hui. Sun may be nahi hui. Sun, seventh ka was strong significator hai. Aur kahan ka significator hai Sun? Ek kafi hota hai. Sun agar seventh ko signify kar raha hai, to as a Mahadasha Lord, sufficient to give marriage. Then Sun is... सन का सब लॉर्ड कौन है? जुपिटर है. व्हाट इज जुपिटर सिग्निफाइंग? इट इज सिग्निफाइंग द सेकंड हाउस, अनदर मैरिज सपोर्टिंग हाउस. फिफ्थ हाउस, अनदर मैरिज सपोर्टिंग हाउस. ओके एंड व्हाट एल्स? ओके इट इज सिग्निफाइंग द टेंथ हाउस बट मेजरली इट इज सपोर्टिंग मैरिज. तो सन, सन एज द महादशा लॉर्ड एंड द स्टेलर लेवल सिग्निफिकेटर ऑफ द सेवेंथ हाउस with its sublord Jupiter also supporting, could have, should have given marriage, lekin shaadi nahi hui inki. Marriageable age nikal gai. Theek hai, chaliye ab hum moon pe aa jate hain. Let us say moon mein. From 2000 to 2010, chalo late marriage, 1956 mein birth hui thi. To 2000 jab khatam hoga, then he would have been 44. One can still get married, you know. Aajkal 40s mein shaadi hoti hai. उसके बाद मून की महादशा शुरू हुई. व्हाट इज मून सिग्निफाइंग? मून, मून सिग्निफाइज 10th हाउस. ठीक है, नॉट नॉट अ गुड हाउस बट 11th हाउस आल्सो वेरी स्ट्रांगली इट सिग्निफाइज. सो इट कुड हैव हेल्प्ड इन मैरिज. ओके मून का सब लॉर्ड कौन है? मून का सब लॉर्ड वीनस है. वी हैव सीन दैट वीनस सिग्निफाइज सेकंड एंड 11th बट मून ने भी, इनकी शादी नहीं हुई, आज तक शादी नहीं हुई है. This is a case of denial of marriage. See, all these stellar level significations, inke dasha, mahadasha, antar dasha, marriage giving planets ke nikal gai, but this gentleman could not get married. How this denial of marriage? Now, how to predict denial of marriage? See, this is specially for, you know, new KP astrologers who have just learned or are learning KP. Be very careful, okay? Don't get carried away and give your prediction. Look at, for marriage, what is the golden rule of KP? The seventh cusp sublord should have some connection with the marriage giving houses, that is either second or seventh or 11th. Who is the seventh cusp sublord? देखिए यहां पर, देखिए, लुक एट द कर्सर, इट इज सैटर्न. सो सैटर्न शुड हैव सम कनेक्शन विद द सेकंड हाउस, सेवंथ हाउस और द 11th हाउस. डज इट हैव एनी कनेक्शन? सेकंड हाउस, नो कनेक्शन. सेवंथ हाउस, इट डज नॉट अपीयर हियर आल्सो. 11th हाउस, इट डज नॉट अपीयर. सो देर आर नो कनेक्शंस. बट यहीं पर कैन वी से दैट डिनाइल ऑफ मैरिज इज 100% गिवन? No, we cannot. Here is where, you know, lies the controversy, and that is why I have shown you these books. Go through these books, then you will find out the real secrets of KP astrology. You have to, before putting your stamp and signing as an astrologer that it is a denial of marriage, you have to see the sublord of the cuspal sublord also. Okay, please don't forget sublord of the cuspal sublord also. So who is the sublord of the seventh? It is Saturn. And who is the sublord of the sublord, who is the sublord of Saturn that you will get from here? It is again Saturn. So even if this cusper sublord was not having any connection with 2711, even if it's sublord, had it been some other planet, you know, a marriage giving planet, then also marriage could have fructified, although, albeit with some difficulty. But here, Saturn is the sublord. It does not have any connections with 2711. And its sublord, the sublord of the cusper sublord, which again is Saturn, does not have any connections again with 2711, as we have already seen. So marriage is denied outright. This is actually what we should be doing is, you know, when we take up a chart for seeing an event, we should first look at the sublord. That is the correct way of proceeding. But ye maine khali aapko samjhane ke liye, main ulti seedhi chadha, just to show, you know, so that you don't just, you know, see this stellar, these are called the stellar level significations, and give a prediction that this event is going to take place. No. Please take a look at the cuspal sublord and the sublord of the cuspal sublord before giving your final verdict. This is a very interesting horoscope. Okay. Yeah, aap log, I hope you have understood. If there are any queries, dekhiye, ye agar aap samajh lenge, ये अगर आप समझ लेंगे इस कॉन्सेप्ट को तो आपका कोई भी प्रेडिक्शन गलत नहीं होगा प्रोवाइडेड ऑफ कोर्स नेटल हॉरोस्कोप्स में सी होरडी में तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है टाइम ऑफ बर्थ का नेटल हॉरोस्कोप्स में द टाइम ऑफ बर्थ हैज टू बी स्पॉट ऑन अदरवाइज इफ देयर इज अ डिफरेंस ऑफ बिटवीन 2 to 9 minutes इन द टाइम ऑफ बर्थ ऑल दीज cuspal sublords are likely to change. So your predictions may not be correct if you base them on these sublords. That is the caveat that I put. If you are not sure about the time of birth, don't use the cuspal sublords at all. Phir aap sirf isi se kijiye. Chances are aapke kuch predictions sahi honge, kuch predictions galat. Ya phir inko aap theek kijiye BTR ke dwara. Birth time rectification ke dwara inko aap theek kijiye. That's also very easy in KP. I have been teaching, I have taught 4 batches. They are all sare jo hain wo BTR ke masters hain. They know how to do BTR. It's quite simple. Sunne mein bada wo lagta hai, you know, that's very difficult, you know, and it's sort of, you know, mind ko ekdam puzzle kar deta hai shuru shuru mein. But it is actually quite simple. So I hope this is clear to you. If there are any questions, isi chart mein, the next video that I am going to make, next video, I am going to say, treat the same chart, but justifying another event in this person's life. Okay? Whether it happened or did not happen. And mind you, this person belongs to a very good family, very well-to-do family, Okay? And marriage ke bahut sare proposals aaye. Lekin nothing materialized. He had a couple of love affairs also, but nothing materialized. Okay, so this is the magic of Krishnamurti Paddhati. Hats off to our Guruji, KSK, and thank you so much for watching. Please give me your feedback and join my classes. This is how I teach, and with all due respects to all astrologers teaching KP, bahut kam log aapko jo hai na, sublord ke depth mein bahut kam log le jate hain. सबलॉर्ड के डेप्थ में ले जाएंगे बट सबलॉर्ड का सबलॉर्ड को भी देखना पड़ता है यू नो दैट प्रोबेबली पीपल फाइंड इट टू टीडियस बट देयर इज अ यू नो देयर इज एन अप्रोच इफ यू डू इट स्टेप वाइज इफ यू गो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट अप्रोच एंड इफ यू हैव द टाइम ऑफ बर्थ करेक्टली द हॉरोस्कोप इज करेक्टली कास्टेड यू कैन इजिली मेक 100% करेक्ट प्रेडिक्शंस थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग डू ज्वाइन माई क्लासेस ओके I am expecting, I have some students, maine bataya personal reasons ke chalte, I have sort of deferred the start of the classes, but do join my classes. Thanks a lot for watching and have a good evening, good day. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.